Hey everyone, welcome back to the channel. Today, I'm going to share with you guys a really cool keyboard project that I came across that I'm sure a lot of you will find interesting. Of course, I'm talking about the Flux keyboard. Now this keyboard isn't officially released yet, but backing on Kickstarter has opened, and now's a great time to pre-order one at a discounted price if you're interested. Obviously, there are risks to backing Kickstarters, so carefully consider if it's right for you before you do so. This keyboard has some awesome features, but the main one is an integrated Full HD display that is completely customizable. In their trailer video, they not only show the capabilities of changing different wallpapers on the keyboard, but also how practical it can be. For one, because the legends are on the screen and not the keycaps, you're able to set them to whatever you like. So if you have a particular font or language you prefer, you'll be able to set it on your keyboard and switch between them on the fly. This can be really useful if you often type in multiple languages or want a larger font for better legibility. Furthermore, the keyboard will be able to react to the different applications you're using on your computer and change its display to match. So for example, if you open up Photoshop, your keyboard will display all your relevant hotkeys right there on the keyboard for you to easily reference. They actually did the math on how much time you would save if you use hotkeys instead of clicking things with your mouse. The result came out to 15 minutes per workday, or 60 hours per year. That is a lot of time. This keyboard is such a great idea for people wanting to increase their efficiency without needing to memorize every single hotkey. And the best part is, this works with way more applications than just Photoshop. On their website, they list 12 in total, including Premiere Pro, DaVinci Resolve, and Fusion 360. I actually edit all my videos with DaVinci Resolve, and I've only learned like 3 hotkeys so far, so having a Flux keyboard could be a great way for me to learn more. The keys are set in a removable frame, which makes it possible to instantly switch them out. For now, there are 2 varieties, tactile and linear. In order to get the 97% transparency look, the Flux uses maglev analog Hall effect switches. Being an analog switch, the keyboard also features software adjustable actuation points of 0.1mm increments, as well as rapid trigger functionality. These are said to have benefits for gaming. Saying an earlier actuation means faster response, as there is less distance to travel. On the flip side, setting a later actuation can prevent misclicks of certain keys. Rapid trigger means that the switch doesn't have to fully return before you can activate it again, which is helpful for situations where you need to spam a key as fast as possible. If you want to learn more about the stats of the Flux keyboard, they're on their website neatly organized for you to check out. There's also a top section of the keyboard that allows for up to 4 add-on modules to be swapped in for more options and customization. By default, the keyboard features passive modules, providing a wide window above the keyboard to display information such as weather and system information. The side dial module can be used as a scroll wheel, volume wheel, or as a customized input for supported apps. The triple key module is pretty straightforward. It adds 3 extra macro buttons that you can fully customize. Use it to control things like your music or voice calls, or even a funny little cat game. The last module is the triple dial module. It features 3 smooth dials for adjusting multiple variables in supported applications. The responsive display below the dials indicates the function and status of each variable. These modules have a lot of utility to them, mainly focusing around productivity. They can completely transform your keyboard into a super efficient tool with countless possibilities. They can further help you save time in your workflow, or just assist you in multitasking different applications. If you guys are familiar with my channel, you're probably already drawing comparisons between this keyboard and the Fine Mouse Centerpiece. Even though both keyboards are not officially released yet, I still want to discuss and compare them. From the way Fine Mouse was marketing the Centerpiece, they really hyped themselves up by talking about innovation and changing up the keyboard space. From what we were shown, most people found their execution to be gimmicky at best. When I look at the Flux keyboard, I really don't see anything like it. The screen looks way easier to see because the keys are much more transparent and clear. Also, the add-on modules being able to add increased functionality to the board is executed in such an elegant way. Personally, I think the Flux keyboard is a much better value than the Centerpiece. And for that reason, I decided to back the project on Kickstarter, and I will not be purchasing the Centerpiece. There is a pretty decent price discrepancy though, but the Flux looks so interesting and unique to me, I didn't want to pass up on the opportunity. but that's just me. Let me know what you guys think in the comments below. Also, while you're at it, remember to subscribe if you haven't already, and check me out on my other social media platforms too. I recently started posting TikToks, so be sure to follow me there for bite-sized versions of my videos. The Kickstarter for the Flux keyboard was recently opened this week and will end on April 20th. So you guys have plenty of time to check it out and order one for yourself at a discount if you're interested. If you do choose to back the project, please remember to do so responsibly. Understand the risks of Kickstarters and don't spend any money you can't afford losing. Again, their website will be linked down below where you'll find more information on the board as well as a link to get to their Kickstarter page. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.